All my life, I have wanted to drive a sport utility vehicle through an airplane. I just didn't know it until I was presented with the chance to do so by Land Rover. What was the occasion? The launch of the 2014 Land Rover Range Rover Sport, a completely redesigned version of the brand's high-performance SUV. The location was an airfield in Cheltenham, England, where Land Rover had purchased a Boeing 747 and gutted it before building what is perhaps the world's most unusual off-road obstacle course. The first thing you notice when driving a truck up into an airplane is just how tight the margin for error actually is. Land Rover didn't help matters much by parking an old-school Defender just inside the cargo doors and then having me tilt the Range Rover Sport up on an off-camber ramp in order to get around it. Maneuvering a vehicle as large as the Range Rover Sport inside the tight confines of a 747 meant moving ahead inches at a time and keeping a close eye on Land Rover's team of minders, who shared my desire not to drive the SUV through the side of the airplane's fuselage. Once past the first obstacle, it was time to tackle a set of uneven ramps, which had the Range Rover Sport bucking up and down as its four-wheel drive system grabbed whatever grip it could from whatever wheels weren't floating above the ground. I imagine this is a bit what turbulence would feel like if we hit a patch of rough air without a giant SUV-sized seatbelt attached to the Land Rover. Finally, it was time to make the steep climb up to the 747's second deck, where I had a bird's eye view of the cockpit before using the Range Rover Sport's hill descent control system to make my way down an improvised exit ramp hanging from the airplane's gullet. Certainly not what Land Rover's designers had in mind when they programmed that particular feature, but it did the job without complaint. I think the vehicle was level for maybe 5 seconds during my entire time driving that first pass through the jet. I now have a lot more respect for anyone who has to pilot a truck out of a cargo plane while it's actually still moving down the runway. You'll notice that I said first pass through the 747, because once I was down and out, it was time to drive to the second set of ramps that led me up into the airplane from the side, where the Range Rover passed motocross style underneath that top deck that we had just driven on. Strictly one truck at a time inside the jet, however, as load balancing requirements had everyone staying on their best behavior to keep the plane stable and safe, or at least as safe as you can be when you're driving a truck through an airplane with no prior experience. Given that the 2014 Land Rover Range Rover Sport is the fastest model in the automaker's portfolio, it was only natural that we'd be given the chance to use the runways at the airport where the airplane was stationed to make a few top speed runs, as well as test out the SUV's 0 to 100 mile per hour back to zero again capabilities. The 510 horsepower supercharged V8 and 340 horsepower supercharged V6 certainly impressed, but there's no question that driving the Land Rover Range Rover Sport through a jet airliner was the highlight of my experience.